if you looked at the country, it was broken down. There was no infrastructure, there was no money, there was no public service, there was nothing except perhaps most visible dead bodies across the entire nation. In every valley, on every stream, in every shrub, in every house, on every street were scattered corpses, dead bodies across, and dogs and birds of the prey of the air feasting on the human corpses across the entire nation. So there was so much stench everywhere. So the smell of death, the smell of destruction, decomposing bodies, a state of hopelessness. As the forces moved around, the liberation forces, the people kept pointing at people that had committed genocide. And so they kept arresting people. Across the nation, so many detainees were rounded up. There were so many competing interests. So one, you had the government, the new government, that had to assert its authority, had to prove its worth. Second, you had all these people in prison. You had to find a way of judging them. You can't keep them in prison forever without trial. Three, there was a cry for justice from the survivors of genocide. Try them. Give us justice. Actually, some of them were saying, kill them. They have killed our people. And then you had the friends, the international community. Oh, justice delayed is justice denied. The state had to find a way of dealing with this crisis. So we put in place special chambers to try them, special prosecutors. I think the first conviction on 23rd March, 96. But by 99, it was clear. We had tried maybe about 300 to 350 cases only. So you still had more than 200,000 in prison. You could not handle that kind of caseload using the traditional Western type of justice. And so people started debating, is there another way? And so a decision was made that let's try other alternatives. They tried everything you can think about, didn't work. Until we zeroed down on Gacaca, an old traditional tested conflict resolution mechanism. So we used that concept to develop something that would be able to deal with justice here. And so, for the first time in the history of any legal system that I know of, the victims of the crime of genocide sat together with the perpetrators or the relatives of the perpetrators to judge one of their own. Is a starting point for the healing.
Inkiko Gacaca zatangijwe mu bihe bibiri by'ingenzi. Igihe cya mbere zatangijwe mu cyiciro cy'icyitegererezo, aho zatangijwe mu mirenge 118, hanyuma ziza gutangira mu gihugu cyose, bakuvuga mu mirenge 1545. Ku birebana rero n'iburanisha ry'imanza, twatangije imanza muri ya mirenge nanone y'icyitegererezo ku itariki ya 10 z'ukwezi kwa gatatu mu mwaka w'2025. Hanyuma ku rwego rw'igihugu zitangira nyuma y'ikusanyamakuru mu gihugu cyose ku itariki ya 15 z'ukwezi kwa karindwi mu mwaka w'2026. Mu ntangiriro Gacaca itekerezwa, urukiko rwayo rugizwe n'inyangamugayo 19 n'abasimbura 5, ariko kugira ngo rushobore kuba rwatangira imirimo yarwo hagomba kuboneka abantu nibura 15. Uko imirimo y'inkiko Gacaca yagiye itera imbere, uwo mubare wagiye ugabanywa, kubera ko byagaragaraga ko guhuza abo bantu bose 15 icyarimwe kugira ngo imirimo ishobore gutangira ku gihe byari bigoye.
There was an element of risk in the sense of taking the decision, but also there was an element of hope that it may work. People had to have the belief and their capacity to sort out this matter.
Inkiko Gacaca dushoje zari zigeze ku manza zigera kuri miliyoni ebyiri.
Close to 2 million dossiers that were judged on account of genocide in our prisons now there are only about 37,000. So where are the rest? They've been reintegrated into the community. They're doing community work here and there. They're back, they're living in their communities. There are no villages for survivors and villages for the perpetrator. They live side by side, maybe 5 meters apart. One is a survivor, another one is a perpetrator. And they live together harmoniously in the community. Those that have been released on conditional release on compassionate grounds have found a welcome reception at home, even from the survivors. And when there is community work, the Umuganda, they will go to work together.
Muri Gacaca rero imirimo yose ikorwa n'abaturage, abacamanza n'abaturage, abatanga buhamya abashinja n'abashinjura n'abaturage, abarega n'abaturage. Byabaye ngombwa ko abaturage bitanga, ntibatinye izuba, ntibatinye imvura, yemwe sinatinya kuvuga ko batatinye n'inzara n'inyota, ariko icyo biyemeje bakakigeraho, bakadufasha nk'abanyarwanda, bakadufasha nk'igihugu kugera ku ntego twari twihaye dushyiraho inkiko Gacaca. Ibyaha bishya bizaboneka cyangwa se ibyaba bitaratunganye mu mirimo yakozwe n'inkiko Gacaca bizakomeza gusuzumwa n'inkiko zisanzwe ndetse na komite z'abunzi kubirebana n'imitungo, kuko nkuko twese tubizi uretse n'iby'inkiko Gacaca zaburanishije wenda bikaba byazagaragaramo ibibazo, ariko nta nubwo twakwihandagaza ngo twemeze ko n'ibyaha byose bya jenoside byaburanishije.
Ko Gacaca ni itegeko kuri buri munyarwanda. Umuntu wese udatanze cyangwa wanze gutanga ubuhamya ku byo yabonye cyangwa azi kimwe n'ubeshye mu buhamya atanze, akurikiranwa n'urukiko Gacaca rumutahuye. Ahanishwa igihano cy'igifungo cyo kuva ku mezi 3 kugeza ku mezi 6.
Mwabiteze amatwi, ndabasaba dufatanye hataza kugira ugwa mu mutego wa kira kintu, sibyo? Uko itegeko ntago ari indirimbo turirimbye, ni itegeko. Abasomere ingingo ya 71.
Today is an important day in this little village in southern Rwanda. Perhaps justice is about to catch up with the last of those responsible for the genocide here. This is the man who is to be tried. His name is Cassian. There are those in the village who say he was involved in the murder of Tutsis, although others dispute this. He, of course, denies the accusation. Witnesses have been called from near and far, and now everyone will try to remember what happened during those terrifying, chaotic days in 1994. A few of the witnesses have already been convicted of genocide. Dressed in their pink prison uniforms, they sit and wait for their turn. Will they support Cassian, or are they going to denounce him? No one knows how the day will end. The first hours are taken up with formalities, but then the witnesses come forward. During the genocide, Hutu militias set up roadblocks throughout the country, at which they captured and murdered fleeing Tutsis. Cassian was seen at one of these roadblocks. Several witnesses are certain of this, but time has passed and memories have faded.
Hari gahondo hafi iwacu nyijyanyweho ku ngufu.
Wigezeho mwakozeho ibiki?
Ntacyo, ahubwo ni jyewe bari bagiye kuhicira.
Wagiye nk'ugiye kwicirwaho cyangwa wagiye nk'ugiye?
Nagiye nk'ugiye kwicwa, kuko n'igitero cyanteye iwanjye kiranjyana, banahankomerekeza mu mutwe, banjyana kuri bariyeri. Bandegaga ko ntabafasha kujya kuri bariyeri nyine ubwo ngubwo, ariko nicyatumye ntayijyaho intambara igitangira hari mukuru wanje bajyanye mbere ngo bagiye mu bitero bahita bamwicisa zanje baza bavuga ngo nabatutsi bene bo bamwishe ubwo rero nanjye nabaye mu rugo hamwe n'abandi mu muryango dutegereje gupfa ubwo nyuma bakoze inama nkabavuye kwica uwo mukuru wanje bajya inama yo kugira ngo bankurikizeho nanjye nicwe muri ubwo buryo bajirisha ko banjyanye mu gitero.
Cassian admits that he often carried an axe, but he claims he used it only to chop wood.
Icyo nabanje kubona hanga harimo ceceka iteye ubwoba niba koko abanyarwanda tugeze muri 2009 turi muri ceceka sinzi ko hari n'amajyambere tuzagera na vision y'avenire nta izagerwa kuko biteye ubwoba niba umuntu wamabaza ati wari uri muri iki gihugu ke ko nari ku kanyaru ko namenya gukana ko bamuvumbuye aha bamwikiye wagendaga mu bitera yagendaga bivuga ko ntarazi ko hazabaho gacaca yahitaga bisubiramo akavuga n'uwo bishe n'abo bishe nuko banganaga harimo ikintu kiyishemo nk'umuntu w'umucamanza yagi noneho barangiza wagera ngo ahantu ngo bajya kubatemesha ibihuru ntabwo icyo gihe hatemwaga ibihuru hatemwaga umuntu witwa umututsi tubivuga tubyatu ariko abacamanza ndagira ngo bashishoze nk'abacamanza nk'abanyarwanda bashaka
duhakanya turi kuri.
A man turns up unexpectedly, wanting to testify that he actually saw Cassian commit
murder.
Araza ageze muhira yararimo mu bantu bishi wacu yicu umukuru wanje
ngo yaje mu gitero
gitwaga cy'umutwe witwa ngo ibinyange
ibinyange
noneho bageze muhira
bageze iwanyu
bageze iwacu papa yarapfuye na mukuru wanje yombira noneho yicamo uwo bita Kalisa.
Papa nawe na mukuru wawe bapfuye uwo munsi?
Bapfuye uwo munsi. Ariko uwo nabashije kubona yishe ni uwo bita Kalisa.
Then the main witness arrives, a man who has been convicted and served his sentence for participating in the genocide. He has confessed, repented, and has therefore been released ahead of time. He knows that he can be sent back to prison if he lies. He describes the murdering without sentiment.
C'est une évidence. Maintenant, on est presque à la fin du travail des juridictions Gacaca. Et je pense qu'on a atteint les résultats et les objectifs qu'on attendait du système Gacaca. Et parmi les objectifs qu'on attendait, justement, c'était aussi de pouvoir permettre d'arriver à la réconciliation nationale. Au départ, quand nous avons commencé le système Gacaca, on avait à peu près plus de 120 000 personnes qui attendaient d'être jugées. Et il était évident que sans justice, on ne pouvait pas parler de réconciliation.
The Tutsis are a minority of the country's population. And when they took power in the wake of the genocide, they realized that justice must include reconciliation and forgiveness if continued coexistence between Hutu and Tutsi were to be possible. Resolution with those who had committed the genocide demanded a new sort of law.
Pas d'une justice, d'avoir une justice qui réprime seulement, mais une justice qui permet à la personne qui a commis les faits de pouvoir avouer, demander pardon à la victime et aussi à la population. Une fois le pardon accordé, c'est aussi une façon pour la population d'accepter cette personne, une fois les peines réduites et une fois que la personne retourne dans la communauté.
Rwanda's justice minister admits it was legally flawed, but he says Gacaca worked because it was true to what mattered.
Has the truth come out as one test of justice? Is the truth, is it transparent? Yes. Has the accused person been given the opportunity to defend himself or herself? Yes. If those conditions are met, then justice has been rendered. It's about substance, not about form.
For the Hutu killers too, the courts helped bring reconciliation unthinkable a decade ago. Rwanda's genocide was too violent and too recent for its demons to vanish entirely, but Gacaca helped push them aside in ways that nobody dared hope. Peter Grester, Al Jazeera, Kigali.